Hello everyone and welcome to another broadcast. This will be the second game I will be casting during the series of me and Kenshiro. So this game goes a little bit faster, let me just show it to you a little second. Okay, you were too slow. Or maybe some people might have seen it, I don't know, but this game was really a lot faster. So yeah, again, in the beginning there doesn't really happen much. I just should fill this time with some random talking, but about what? Well, anyways, let's just enjoy this game because it was pretty good for bronze versus silver. So let me just hide that tab for you. Okay, there we go. And if the game gets laggy, don't worry, it's just my computer, not yours, because I'm currently rendering out two other projects I have been doing, and yeah, that creates some lag. So Kenshiro going for the barracks right here, not walling off, not standard for Terran, but maybe is afraid that I will go void race and then I can charge him up right here and just kill all of his marines and siege tanks. So I think his barracks will finish a bit faster than my gateway. Oh no, not at all. So we're both keep making workers. Kenshiro, his gas also a bit later than mine. And I'm getting my cybernetic score right now. So I was doing the foregate here. Still, yep, it got nerfed. Don't know if you may call this nerfed, but at a 20 second delay, it is not much. But it can really make a huge a Kenshiro scouting to the right, wrong position here. Do you actually see these rocks here? Yeah. That was not smart of you. But yeah, still with the 20 second nerf, it is not much. It can play a huge role in your foregate attack if you go for it. But I actually have a game that I might cast where the foregate is pretty good, but you need to get your gateway very, very early right now, so you can't build like a good economy in the early game. So yeah, now saving up for my warp gates. There should be a probe somewhere around here. So yeah, I always like to get my gateway on 10, cybernetics on, no, then assimilator on 13, cybernetics on 15, my second pylon on 16, but I most likely forget that. Then just keep making two probes, the pylon will finish, then get out a zealot or a stalker, depends on how much gas you have. And on 20 start researching the warp gate, so it will be like immediately after your pylon finishes, because then you have 18 supply, create a zealot, creates 2 supply, and then you can immediately go to the cybernetics. So that's how I like to do my foregate, and the timing can be pretty good if you save your chrono boosts, do everything right, then your timing will be nearly as the time before the nerf. So yeah, and again, Kenshiro here getting a lot of barracks once again. He likes going for mass marines in this game. Only has 2 at the moment. Then getting a lot of reactors. This barracks here failing a bit with the placement, this one too. So Kenshiro is still with this SCV just hanging around. So now my warp gate's finished at the 6 minute 20 seconds. Then my warp gate's finished, but I had to waste some chrono boost on probes because I didn't continuously make them. Made them. Wow, my English is just awesome today. So And then you can basically like use all your chrono boosts on the warp gate. Then you will get a really fast warp gate. It will hurt your economy a lot. So if your warp gate fails, you are a lot behind in terms of economy. So yeah, now let's go back to the game. I'm trying down my proxy pylon over here. And let's take a look at the actions per minute. Oh, that's the army tab. So income, I'm still ahead of Kenshiro, but if some of you guys have watched my previous game I've cast of Kenshiro, then you will see that his economy is not the best, but also not the worst. He got a lot better since I've told him just keep making workers, it's really good. And then you can actually, yeah, continuously make units of these barracks. So now he's not making anything, has like 200 minerals saved up just for nothing. And whenever he will reach like the count, he needs to make how many marines is it? 1, 2. Let me say 9 marines. So yeah, here we have a battle going on. Stalkers are just owning the marines. Only lost, I think, one stalker and one zealot during the process. So now just killing the reactors, and one marine just get cancelled. Killing the tech lab, don't want them to get stimpack because that can really hurt. And now warping in some additional stalkers, not supply blocking myself, always look after that. And yeah, Kenshiro now forced to pull SCVs, not the mule, and there he goes, mule is dead. So now these marines, okay, that reactor is down, and I'm like, okay, now I have this game in the back. Even if there is like a factory over there, I still win it, no matter what. So there's the GG, kind of weird GG though, but yeah, he did well. But if I can give you a little tip, Kenshiro, just do not make these 5 barracks at once, because your economy can't handle that when you're just on one base. If you have 2 bases, it's fine, but I've never seen a game where like people get 5 barracks and before the 10-minute mark, and you even go for reactors in that. So that means if you go for all reactors, not like you did here with Tech Lab, so if you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 reactors, that means 10 marines, so you need to have 1000 minerals every 25 seconds. And yeah, your economy just can't handle that. You better can save up some minerals to get like a factory, engineering bay, to get some upgrades. It's really not worth having these 5 barracks at once. At least that's what I think. But yeah, I just want to thank you guys for watching this game, and now I'm gonna go to the third game while this game and the previous game is rendering, and one of my other projects, but I'm just gonna keep it secret for now. So thank you guys for watching, and see you all in the next game.